No. I won't save the time. I will... I skip the, our results and proof. It's not working. So... I will prove this one. So, the Cooper thing. New one. Then the only space we U1 is homeomorphic to R plus. The old space. It's like this. Half life. And why is it not? There are many, we can take many ways. Homeomorphism is not unique, but we think of this map as everybody is saying about Mome map. We think projection is just Mome. This is very important. So, the smooth structure of the half line comes from here. So, those smooth structure connected with this knot, this moment knot. This is very important. And T. For any equivalent diffeomorphism, which induces the orbit map.
Long part is what?
Ah, that's this is different. We can prove. Precisely, look at the book of Bredon's famous book, compact Bredon book. We can see a precise proof. This is the different. This is actually different. And this map is given precisely. This map can write like this. Some people look strange because it takes root. But actually, this is smooth. By a Taylor expansion, it's easy to see. And it's large psi, north. Which is given by the following equation. For any smooth homomorphisms of the orbit space, it is given by is given by this equation. It's not difficult to this is also diffeomorphism. Look at the precisely Breton's book. And then this map psi f is equivalent diffeomorphisms of the plane. And psi is right inverse of P. This is also a group. I'm sorry. This is a group homomorphism. Group epimorphism. And this is also a group. I'm sorry. this is group homomorphism. This is a group epimorphism. Kernel T. If it is containing a kernel, then the P H is identity. The orbit space identity. Which means orbit preserved. Orbit means this orbit. Each orbit preserved. Preserving equivalent diffeomorphisms. The orbit is circle. And then if if G is so this is a circle to circle, and U1 to U1, the equivalent diffeomorphism, then this equivalent diffeomorphism is written like this. Z sum W. It's easy to see the equivalent map from U1 to U1 is right multiplication with some element. So equivalent diffeomorphisms of U1 to U1, generally Z to Z, the equivalent diffeomorphisms U1 U is just as much to G. Or you, this is U1. So H do not have from O space to U1 such that I think the X is contained in this is a real number, is contained in a complex number, I think. Which means that so equivalent diffeomorphisms of orbit preserving equivalent diffeomorphisms for each sub, this point is rotated something like this. If this is a point X, this is a circle of radius R X, then this point is a rotation. It's the angle is theta, then this point is right E. So this is contained. Rotate. So this point goes into here, this point here, then we have something like this way. This is the map. The angle is each point assigns the rotation angle, rotation U1. And what we write X square, okay, that's because we think of projection as a moment, the square, Z to absolute number square. Anyway, this is, then we can extend equivalently. Then we see that. Sorry, this number. Smooth map, because this is defined from Smooth map. And also we can prove that this H, ah, excuse me, this is not plus, not here, because at the origin, we can't determine the rotation, except origin.
Only one fixed point. Origin is just a, only one fixed point.
Yes, yes, only one fixed point. Otherwise, it's rotating. Yeah. Yes. Then, extend. To the origin. By Taylor expansion, we can prove this kind of extent.
Is extension smooth?
Yes, smooth extension. Yes. This is a very essential point, because it gives the information of the singular point, at the singular point. Mm. So this is very, very important. Let large air denote for each kernel P, kernel, so orbital preserving map, assigning A bar H, not A bar H, but took its index, because this is an anti-group homomorphism. If we take inverse, then this is a group forms. Also, this is isomorphic. To U1. Which is given by A bar any equivalent of your monitoring is not orbital preserving. So, and P. If it, okay, it's just. This is right index. So H is here. P is different margins of the point. And compose this psi 1, psi. Take this inverse and compose it. Compose this. Then we, if we take this, this is group homology. Okay. So this is identity now. So this contains the kernel of the orbit prism. Compose the right inverse. Take its inverse. Then its orbit prism. Now then we can take neighbor. Each orbit preserving defines this one. So, I'll take its inverse because this is. Group isomorphism. Okay. Now we define. Are there any questions? Composing these two maps. This is phi here. And this is this map. Then we can prove it is a group epimorphism. For any like this group epimorphism. Next we think of map E. That's the usual exponential map. Exponential map. Like we do not write E. We shall prove that kernel P is contained in we shall prove this. Okay, I'm sure if this thing is proved, then easily and directly our result. It is sufficient. I'm showing at the end of proof. I can prove this one is not false. So,
excuse me, here I'm a little confused. So you say phi is d u 1 c 2 u 1, but a is actually a function. So you evaluate some point or?
I'm sorry, for you. I'm sorry.
ちょっと待って。あ、ここでいいの。あ、いいんですよね。あ、ゼロ。
I'm sorry. No, something is wrong. Yes. Just moment. Something is wrong. Yes. Something is wrong. AH. Zero. I'm sorry. Zero. 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 Ah. Thank you.
You said it's...
Yeah. I'm sorry. Zero. Ah, yeah. Zero is... So this gives information, let's say, origin. The origin is only one singular point as a function. Here, there's a...
Excuse me. So can you recover A bar from the data at zero?
Yes.
A bar is extended. AH is extended.
Yes.
But once we get the data at zero, so can we recover all A bar?
That's the infinitesimal.
I won't recover, but.
It's only the limit of
Yeah. And this means this is an invariant of equivalent diffeomorphisms.
Okay.
Which gives invariant.
Okay.
Yes.
If you evaluate this, you extend it to zero up to zero.
Why
don't you just evaluate this at one?
Because
it doesn't give you any invariant.
Because except origin, this is one orbit type. Except this is two orbit type origin, and the other point is easy to manage. But this point is more difficult point. So this
you
information
want to behavior about this.
Yes. This information, from this information, gives the first module, the information, first module. Just that means this equivalent diffeomorphism, the first module is, and the information is determined by from here. That's the first homology group, U1 times R.
So U1 is the data in zero.
Yes. Yes. Some that's invariant. It's an invariant. For first homology group.
It makes sense, yeah.
Okay.
So you have
30 minutes. Yeah. Okay. In this field, there's a most basic lemma, fragmentation lemma. I'll explain it. this lemma is true for any smooth G manifold. For any compact group in the smooth manifold should be connected. I don't like to connect the smooth. And UFA be open covering. Of N. Equivariant. This is equivariant. Which means open cover in and by invariant. Invariant means G.
G status.
Yeah, yeah, G. G. G alpha I, then G alpha. And then they exist a neighborhood of identity in this diffeomorphism. This is also topological group by a infinite topology, and as I said, here I use I'm thinking about only a group structure, but the topology again here. And such that for any element of diffeomorphism, this is equivalent diffeomorphism. They exist H I N for some number of elements in M such that H can H is written H 1 opposite H 2 H k, and each support of H I is contain some open set U alpha I. Here alpha I is index, some index. What does it mean? It means that any equivalent diffeomorphisms is written for this neighborhood. That here we think of infinite topology, and the neighborhood is means that it's close to the identity. Any differentials we can if it take it small, then we can make distance also derivation. Anything can take small, and any equivalent diffeomorphisms is written compose small equivalent diffeomorphisms. Also, each equivalent diffeomorphism is the support contains one this open set. Okay. This is called fragmentation lemma. For those problems, we need always this fragmentation computation lemma.
So any diffeomorphism can be a composite, finite composition of very small,
yes,
small changes in an equivalent neighbor.
Yes.
And
yes,
then the composition.
Yes, yes. Yes. Because this is a topological group. Except this one. It's a trivial.
Yeah.
But
we can basically,
yes,
support.
So by the fragment, fragmentation lemma, we can assume. So we want to prove this one. So let's take H. By the fragmentation lemma, and we take this is C. And so we take an open invariant of covering. This one and this one. Then a very small disk, like small disk. This is small disk. Okay, then we can assume. H is throws to the identity and support H is contained in small is delta. That is a positive number. Its support is contained in small case. And because other side, this is one of its type. And we use the previous result. If it is one of its type, this is perfect. Then we can write, if the support is contained here, this one of its type, but previous result, we can prove, we can see that this equivalent diffeomorphism is right, is written by a commutator, because this is perfect. So we don't need this one. So we only think of this one, which support is contained in delta net. Now that H is kernel T, so by definition, and theta is defined, each equivalent diffeomorphism, H, which it defines this one. And the kernel then this, that, this must be go to the unit element of U1, which means this is a unit. But it is common. It, we take, because this is also a kernel of P. This, so the kernel, if it contains a kernel theta, if and only if it is contained kernel of phi, also it contains kernel of P. So, if it's it contains the kernel, then this is pH is identity, and the group size, group isomorphism, then this is identity. And also, this is also because phi H is containing kernel phi. So, also this is unit element. That means either zero is identity. So, from this, identity. We can lift to this mark, alpha H.
R plus is simply connected, so you can lift. This is a covering space.
Yeah. I'm sorry. Yeah.
Okay.
AH bar extended to AH bar.
And so by fragmenting your theorem, we can take it close to the identity. So in that case, AH bar is also close to unit theorem, constant map. Mm-hmm. Okay. Alpha H is close to zero. Zero map. Then we can reuse it. It's a key then map. Here. For any left, for positive number delta, and you be smooth function. Function such that support U is contained in zero delta, and close to zero. But explicitly, C1 close is enough. C1 close to zero. That there exists a smooth function V, and the homomorphisms of the orbit space got plus. Such that support we is contained in this is key human, but it's hard to see. But we write a picture, it's very, very easy to see. Which means that, like this, this is R plus, this size R, then for smooth map, you need like this. This is you. And support is containing that. And if we take phi x and satisfying this condition, we take phi x is defined by x plus ux, then phi is like this. This is phi. And we breathe like this. Satisfying this condition. And the important thing is this one. This condition is very important relation to prove. Satisfying this condition for this is u, for each u, this is v. We need satisfying this one each u, they exist equivalent homomorphisms and v. Just this picture. Then we can prove our result. We apply that lemma to alpha h. Alpha h is like this. Yes, alpha h is like this. This condition. Yes, alpha h and support is contained in zero delta and C1 close. Then this is diffeomorphisms. Otherwise, this is not. So C1 close, so this is diffeomorphism. So this contains this creation. Compose this exponential map then, so, V is not R plus 2R. Compose exponential map. This is map from here to here. So this defines this. This defines this element. Take its inverse. Inverse means if you take this one, then it's containing current. So this containing current. And H2.
How this L was defined? Was it did you give L, this map? L. Oh, L was given. Okay.
H2 equals psi phi. That's right. Phi is different origins. Half right.
Orbit space.
So this contains equivalent different origins. Then by calculate by those definition, we see that the following relation which contains is complex current. So this composition is contains commutator. We should calculate. To satisfy this calculation, this is the same relation. This is just as this relation induces this relation. Then prove that current theta was contained in current theta and current and this is contained current t also and a Because first I took H contained in kernel theta. So this is contained in kernel theta. Because this is this contains kernel T. And also and this goes to zero because H is contains kernel T. Okay. So zero goes to unit element. It starts with this one. So H bar is the h value equals 1, or alpha h 1 equals 0. So, come. So,
this one should be kernel theta lemma. Commutator subgroup of kernel theta and V1. No,
yes.
This one.
Ah! Then, from this result, there exists a following exact sequence. This is generally for any group. And theta induce the first harmonic group. Theta is mapped from here to here. The group induces the first harmonic group. You know, for any group, there is a sequence of a merge of a group. And from here, this element contain, and this element contain here. That means, so our sentence.
Questions or comments?